The pasuk says, "Daber al bnei Yisrael, speak to the Jewish people, saying, B'chodesh ha'shvi'i be'echad la'chodesh, in the seventh month, in the first of the month, it should be for you Shabbosayin, a day of rest, Zichrein trua, a day of remembering the sounding of the shofar." So Rashi quotes the word Zichrein trua, remembering the sounding of the shofar, and he explains Zikarein, what is the meaning of memory here? Psukei Zichreinais and Psukei Shofreis, that we say the verses that talk about Hashem remembering us, and we say the verses talking about the shofar, Liskar lachem akedas Yitzchak shekarev tachtav ayil, to remember for you the binding of Isaac, the binding of Yitzchak, that a ram was brought in his stead. So the Rebbe asked the question, the word zichrein trua, to remember the sounding of the shofar, seemed to be something that makes sense, that's obvious, that doesn't need any special interpretation. What's bothering Rashi? Some explain that Rashi's bothered that later it will say in Parshas Pinchas, in the portion of Pinchas, Yoim Teruah, day of sounding the shofar. Here it says, Zichrein Teruah, remembering the sounding of the shofar. So Rashi explains that here it means the mention of the verses of Zichreinus and the verses of shofros. However, it's hard to explain it that way, says the Rebbe, because in addition to the fact that if that was the case, Rashi should have specified the question, that it's a contradiction between this verse and the other verse. Also, their general rule is that Rashi addresses a contradiction between two verses, or an implied contradiction between two verses, when we get to the second one, because that's the one that raises the question. So why here would we address it in this case, in Emor, in the first instance, it should have been left to deal with the seeming contradiction when we get up to the second mention in the portion of Pinchas. Also, says the Rebbe, you have to understand the other way around. In the simple sense, in the Pshutei Shel Mikra, in the simple understanding of the text, how does Rashi actually know that Zichrein Trua, that a remembrance of the sounding of the shofar, tells you that you need to say the verses of memory and the verses of shofros? In addition to that, he asked several questions about the Rashi itself. The simple explanation is that Rashi's explaining that the memory is a reference to the verses of Zichronos, and the word Zichrein, and the word Trua, sounding the shofar, is a reference to the verses of Shofros, to the verses that remind us of the sounding the shofar. If that's the case, asks the Rebbe, why? The simple meaning of the text, Zichrein Trua, the way the word is vocalized, the vowels of the word Zichrein imply that it's connected to the word Trua. In other words, it's not two separate things, a memory and a shofar, but rather Zichron Trua, a memory of the shofar. If that's the case, that only tells us about a requirement to mention the shofar, which would be the verses about shofros. Where does Rashi get that Zichron is a separate thing that's telling you that you need the verses of memory? In addition, after Rashi quotes in the verse the word Zichrein Trua, he again says, Zichrein, what is the meaning of memory? The verses of Zichronos and the verses of Shofros. Why does he need to say it again? And if he does, why doesn't he say both words, Zichrein and Trua? Furthermore, Rashi continues and explains the reason for saying these verses is in order to remember the binding of Yitzchak, that instead of him, a ram was brought. Rashi generally doesn't tell us the reasons for the mitzvot, for the commandments. Why over here does he feel a need to specify the reason? So the Rebbe explains all of this by saying that what Rashi here is really bothered by is not by so much to explain the words Zichrein Trua, but rather to explain the whole content of Yi'alachem, that it should be for you a Zichrein Trua, a remembrance of the shofar, but that needs explanation. Why? The verse says it should be for you a remembrance of the sounding of the shofar, which implies that this is an instruction to the Jewish people that each of us should have a zichrein through a reminder of the sounding of the shofar. But that doesn't seem to tell us what it means. What does it mean to remember? What does it mean to remember the sounding of the shofar? What exactly are we being told to do? So that's why Rashi explains that what is it referring to? It's referring to saying the verses of Zichronos and Shofares. In other words, he means to say that it's not just instructing us to remember. It's instructing us to do a particular act of remembrance, saying the verses. And that's hinted at in the word Zichren Trua. Zichren, to remember, means to pay special attention. Similarly to what Rashi explained in the words, Zachar es Yema Shabbos, remember the Shabbos day, that any day that you come across something specifically nice throughout the entire week, you should remember Shabbos by putting it aside for Shabbos. So similarly here, he explains that what does it mean to remember the sounding of the shofar? It's an instruction about a specific action we need to take in that remembrance, to say the verses of Shofros. But still, you'll have the question, why does the Torah say this instruction as a remembrance? Usually remembrance applies when there'd be room to forget. And that's why you need a specific instruction to make sure to remember. Zachar es Yom HaShabbos, remember the Shabbos day, because it's instructing us that all week long, even when we're busy with everything else, we should still remember Shabbos. So that makes sense. You could have forgotten it, you need to remember it. When Joseph asked the Sar Hamashkim, Paro's butler, to remember him to Paro, it's because he's going to leave prison. And in fact, he won't want to remember any longer what brought him to prison and what brought him out of prison, etc. So he needs a specific request. Please make sure to remember me. But in this case, what do you need a remembrance? If it's one day of Rosh Hashanah, what does it mean that on Rosh Hashanah you have to remember the shofar? It's just one day. Obviously you remember whatever's relevant. There's no forgetfulness that seems to apply. And to explain this, Rashi explains that Zichra in Trua, when the verse says to remember the shofar, is to emphasize and include not just the idea of shofreis, that you're going to remember the shofar, but actually that there is an element of remembrance itself. Zichreinos, that the verses of remembrance are a separate thing, that it's not just one consecutive statement, Zichrein Trua, remembering the shofar, but it's two separate things. Zichrein, you should have a remembrance, which is to focus on the verses of remembrance, and shofar, and remember the verses of the shofros. Why? Still, doesn't remembrance apply to something specific that you're going to do something to remember? What does it mean to remember the remembrance? So that's why Rashi explains it's to remind you of Akedas Yitzchak, of the binding of Isaac. In other words, that the focus of this remembrance isn't so much that we'll remember. Of course, it's Rosh Hashanah, it's one day we'll remember. But rather, it's to awaken God's remembrance. In other words, the focus here is that God should do something that will cause God to remember for us the merits. And Rashi says that what is that? To remember the binding of Isaac. He says that not immediately after saying the verses of remembrance of Zichreinos, but rather, which seems to be where it applies, but rather only after mentioning also Trua, the verses of Shofros. Why? Because he's emphasizing that when we say the verses of Shofros, that's also for the same purpose. It's in order to awaken God's remembrance of the merits of the Jewish people. And that's why he concludes to remember for you that instead of Yitzchak, a ram was brought, because that emphasizes the connection not only of the verses of remembrance, but also the connection of the remembrance to the verses of Shofros as well, to the verses that talk about the shofar as well. Why? Because as mentioned, the simple meaning of the words Zichra in Trua would imply that Zichra in Trua, a remembrance of the shofar, is one statement, not two separate things. And therefore, Rashi wants to learn that when we're talking about the shofros, the verses that relate to sounding the shofar, also it's in order to accomplish an aspect of zikaron. It's in order to accomplish a remembrance that God should remember. And that's why he needs to interpret that the verses of shofros is to remember for you the binding of Yitzchak, that instead of him was brought a ram, because the remembrance here is to awaken God's remembrance. Both the verses of Zichreinos and also the verses of Shofros are to awaken God's remembrance of the shofar, of the binding of Yitzchak, that the ram was brought instead of. According to all of this, we could understand why Rashi says again at the beginning of the Rashi an extra time the word zikaron, the word remembrance, and explains that that's a reference to the verses of Shofros. He's telling you that what causes him to need to interpret zikaron as a separate thing, not just as part of Trua, as would be the simple meaning, because it says zikaron, because it uses the word remember when it should have just used the word say the Trua, talk about the Shofar and the like. It emphasizes the word remember. That's what causes Rashi to tell us that we need to say verses of remembrance as opposed to the verses of Shofres, which we learn from the word trua, from the little literal word itself. So he doesn't have to quote it again. And Rashi continues, and the verses of Shofres in order to remember. In other words, if that's the case, that zikaron is a separate thing, then why does it say it as zichra and trua as one continuum, that in the trua, in the Shofar, there's also the idea of remembrance, because there's a remembering, not only remembering, causing, asking God in general to remember our merits, but also the purpose of the verses of Shofros is to cause God to remember the merits contained in the Shofar as well. According to this, you could also explain why Rashi first says the word Zikaron, and then he continues verses of Zichreinais and verses of Shofros, and he doesn't stop and say the word Trua in between, because he's emphasizing that the verses of Shofros are also for the same purpose as Zikaron. They're also in order to remind God of the merits of the binding of Yitzchak, of Akedas Yitzchak.